Just about a month after Automobilista 2 was released, in its supposed 1.0 state, it still has to deal with some major problems and annoyances. For this video, I have put together the three things in AMS2 that I feel hinder its progress the most. And just as a disclaimer before I get started, I may get a bit harsh at times, but this is not in an attempt to make AMS2 or Risa look bad, but rather because the game has so much potential left and could already be so much better. Anyway, the first point in my list is the user interface. Now, don't get me wrong here, the UI in itself is pretty decent, but there are some instances where it can be really annoying. There are two major inconveniences that sadly can be found quite often: ambiguity and a lack of control. The best example for the last mention is probably the single race AI configuration screen. Have you ever configured a single player race against the AI? Well, I certainly have multiple times by now, and time and time again it's really annoying. Like, I choose a track and a car, but when it actually comes to adjusting the AI's aggressiveness and difficulty, the default controls from the Thrustmaster T300 just do not work, which leads to me having to adjust everything by mouse and keyboard. At first glance, this might seem pretty minor, but when you have to do this every time since the beta, and it still isn't fixed yet, then all those minor annoyances combined form a major annoyance. The ambiguity, on the other hand, isn't that prevalent, but nevertheless manages to always catch me off guard. If you hit pause during a session on track, you'll get to this menu. To navigate, you use your up and down keys. So far so good, right? Like, it makes sense given that all options are nicely grouped underneath each other, except those two. And for some reason, you also have to hit up or down to change between them instead of the more logically left and right key. Another strange occurrence can be found directly in the main menu. If you hit the camera symbol in the top left, you get to your saved replays. And now take a guess where a click on your profile name leads to. Right, your saved replays. Then there's also inconsistency. Like, when I'm trying to select a livery for my car, I have to press button 4 to get into the right side of the menu. However, when I'm in the setup screen, I have to press button 7 to get to the individual settings, while button 5 is generally the key that opens advanced settings in the general menus. It wouldn't even be that bad if Risa would display which button you have to press to execute a general action. Like, when I'm selecting a livery, they could change the text box to livery select, then a small gap, and a symbol for button 4, and so on. So, all in all, the whole user interface feels a bit rushed and annoying to navigate through at times. And during the 1.5 months AMS2 is officially out now, it wasn't really improved or fixed either. Another area that urgently needs improvements is the multiplayer. The main problem I see here is a missing incentive for players to race online against others, and also a sort of driver rating regarding how safe and fast a given player is able to race. For example, if I'm in a public lobby, there's no way for me to know what awaits me. There's a good chance of me just racing on my own, either at the front or the back of the grid. Additionally, there's nothing in place to reward or even encourage safe driving and actually finishing races. By now, it's not even bold to assume that everyone who played AMS2 online so far already experienced the lobby's player count decreasing from 12 or so players to about 5 only after the first lap. And this is by no means an exception, but rather the rule. Issues like this cause AMS2's multiplayer section to be as empty as they currently are. For instance, last time I checked was on a Saturday evening, and there was a grand total of 15 players racing each other on two different servers. So if Risa won't interfere in the next few months, it could very well be a devastating blow to Automobilista 2's future. This is generally something I want to dive into later on in the video. But for now, we should take a look at the last major problem, which is the handling of the cars. Now, please bear with me. The game, or rather the physics engine in itself, is actually quite good, but the overall lack of decent default setups for all cars doesn't really allow for it to shine. Like, you could develop the best and most realistic physics engine for a racing game known to mankind, but if you're not willing to edit these two types of default setups, then the part of your player base who are not knowledgeable in setting up a car will struggle and receive the game's experience way worse than it actually could be. Try to look at it like this. You create a setup for track A, which is high speed oriented, has more long stretched corners than tight ones, and no elevations. On the other hand, we have track B, which has lots of tight corners, a hill section, and is relatively low speed. Now, the problem here is, especially when referring to Automobilista 2, that you can't just create one default setup that handles somewhat decently on both tracks. Of course, the solution is quite simple. Just adjust the setup yourself accordingly, so that it fits a given track. But I'm pretty sure not everyone knows how to do this correctly, which will probably lead to a few people quitting the game because of a supposed bad physics engine, which in reality isn't true at all. Yes, I know there are many tracks in AMS 2. Yes, I also know that there are a lot of cars in AMS 2, but at least give us two separate setups where one is a bit safer and the other is more loose. All in all, it is trendily a bit strange by Risa to prioritize pushing out DLCs over actually fixing and improving the core game experience. I mean, yeah, I get it. DLCs potentially pull in more new players and probably also generate more revenue. But wouldn't it be nice to get the new players to continue playing the game? Because right now, this is not happening. And it shows in the player numbers. Additionally, an in-game rating system was already promised to us by Risa back then when Automobilista 2 was still in beta. Yet, nothing was added so far. If you are still watching at this point, chances are you are either completely triggered by my accusations or somewhat agreeing with me. Ultimately, I would be very interested in reading through your own opinions in the comments. Do you agree with me? Am I just incredibly nitpicky? Do you have other things you would like to see Risa working on? So yeah, I hope you enjoyed the video. If so, you could consider subscribing to the channel for my sim racing content. And with that said, I'll catch you in the next one. Cheers!